You're listening to GIGI Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph.
Hey girls, it's Steph here.
Happy Thursday, it's Esther.
So we're almost to the end of our week, and today is our...
conclusion?
Yes, our
part two of Colder Than Thou.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so I have a question for you.
Oh, yes.
Have you ever felt like, or have you ever experienced a time where you didn't have much things, you know, many things, where you didn't have, as in possessions, and you needed stuff?
Honestly, no. I haven't been lacking anything, like not dire, where I was like, I really, really need that. No.
Mm.
Have you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, we have, well, like lots of times. But when we came to Australia, I remember that we didn't have, well, anything besides clothes. But getting everything from scratch was really hard. And we had people, because we came during winter, and we had people, and we had places like the Salvation Army. They all gave us stuff.
Oh, wow.
So jumpers and warm pants, and we had a guy from church bring one of the latest heaters to our home.
Oh, wow.
And people were just coming to our house and just pouring gifts to us, you know, and they didn't have to do that.
That's nice.
But that was very nice. Just that they had more than we did, even though maybe some of them didn't have as, you know, a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
But they had more than we did, and they were willing to share it with us.
How did you feel having people share with you?
I think when I was a little girl, because I was younger then, it was... I didn't really think much about it,
okay,
you know.
Yeah,
I just had stuff. But now as I've gotten older, I do think about it. And it has made an impression in my life. Like all these people and the kindness they showed. And I still remember them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that just makes me, yeah, happy. Think,
wow, that's really good. Yeah, I don't think, like a lot of us here now, girls listening, I think like me, you've grown up pretty privileged, and you've had basically everything you need.
Mm.
Probably not everything you want, which is different.
Different,
but everything that you need. But there is something special about sharing with someone. That is something my mom has taught us.
Mm.
That, you know, when we have people come to our church from other countries, students, whatever, she always says, you know, oh my goodness, you know, we should help them and we give them this. So we, as a family, put things together. I think it's because for her, she remembers what it felt like to get.
And she does say that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
exactly. That's really interesting.
All right. So are we ready for our part two of
the
story?
Oh, my goodness. Yes, I'm dying to know.
Okay, you can read it.
All right. Colder Than You, Part 2. Written by Celeste Perino-Walker and Alex D. Stoffel. The little boy chewed sullenly on his lower lip. It ain't that I don't like you exactly, he growled. It's just that I don't think it's very fair is all. Maya rolled her eyes in exasperation. You think what isn't fair? Oren stared pointedly at Maya's sweaters. Every day you walk by me wearing two beautiful thick sweaters. And every day I sit here dressed in only this thin shirt. The boy fingered the threadbare material of his shirt and looked up at her with accusing eyes. Do you think that's fair? That morning at the breakfast table, Uncle Alvin had read from a very large worn old Bible. One of the verses he'd read had something to do with this exact situation. Maya remembered it perfectly. Peeling off her top sweater, she handed it to the astonished Oren. He reached out with fingers blue from the cold and eagerly pulled the still warm sweater over his head, wrapping his thin arms around himself in a tight bear hug to capture all the warmth he could. He looked up with a shy smile. But Maya wasn't through. She rummaged around in Uncle Alvin's lunch basket and gave Oren half of everything. As she walked on, she realized that she was a little colder on the outside than usual, but she was a lot warmer on the inside than she had ever been before. Wouldn't Uncle Alvin be surprised when he found out where half his lunch had gone? Maya knew she would have fun describing the look of pure joy on Oren's face as he had eaten it.
Did you like the ending?
I did. I did not expect it. It was really interesting.
Mm.
And I have to admit, I don't... It's not that I'm excusing his anger, but I kind of understand he felt... He was jealous, but because of a need.
Mm.
Like he was freezing.
Because he was invisible to her.
Yeah.
She wasn't cold, so she didn't look at the needs of anybody else.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah, I like that story. Mm. It's nice. And I think, girls, it's a good challenge for us.
Yeah.
You might not see someone cold out in the streets, you know, but I think that there will be other people that have needs, and you can supply those needs, even if it's with, you know, some, those packet goods, you know.
Those canned goods that don't go off kind of thing, yeah.
You can do a basket like that. You can just ask your parents if you can go and help in, homeless kitchen. Yeah. Anything like that so that we can get out of ourselves and help.
That's a really good idea. I think sometimes we get a bit self-absorbed. Yes. Like Maya did.
Mm.
And it's, if I don't have a need, I don't notice anybody else has that need that I don't have kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's interesting.
So, it's good. And I think that's a way to share God's love by giving people things that we could
that's
spare.
Really good.
Look through your closet. I'm sure there's things you don't like anymore. You can give that to places like charity, like Salvation Army.
Yeah.
And they were the first people that clothed us when we came to Australia. So you can do the same.
And just
for
make
others.
Sure, they're in good condition. Don't just give like clothes that doesn't. Rags. Give some of the good stuff as well. We're going to go for a break and we'll come back after this song by Rebecca St. James, I Can Trust You.
I know that you
Now, let's get into our question. And it says, I don't really like who I am. How do I learn to love myself? This is so hard, so sad. But yeah, let's see what Danny has to say.
I don't really like who I am. How do I learn to love myself? Oh, precious girl, the best way you can learn to love yourself is to first know how God loves you. As the Bible says, we love because he first loved us. We learn what love is because God himself is love. And boy, oh boy, he has some awesome things to say about you. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. He chose you before the foundation of the world. He knows even the very hairs of your head. They're all numbered. His thoughts towards you are as numerous as the sand on the seashore. He's always thinking about you. You're the apple of his eye. He died for you on the cross at Calvary so that he could be with you forever and ever in heaven. And so don't ever doubt his love for you and your value in him. And I think, you know, sometimes in life we have people speak stuff into us that is so not true. You know, we have an enemy that's prowling around like a lion seeking whom he's going to devour. And, you know, sometimes we take stuff on. You know, sometimes we make mistakes. And the critical thing that we miss in that time is that we think that we are our mistakes. Guilt says you've done something wrong. Shame says you are wrong. And if that's you today, I just want to say, shame off you. And I think the beautiful thing about that is that, you know, the whole reason that Jesus died for us is that we get to have a second chance. And just remember that we are under no obligation to be the same person as we were yesterday. If we've found that we're heading down a wrong track, that we've maybe made some wrong decisions, maybe, you know, we just feel like we've gone too far, let me tell you, you have never, ever gone too far from the reach of God. He has arms that are long enough to reach into the depths of the sea and high enough to lift you out of the deepest valley. And so I think it's really good to just look at even some basic pieces of scripture when we're thinking about, you know, not having that value in ourselves. There's that really famous Bible verse and it says, love the Lord your God with all of your heart, all of your mind, all of your soul, and all of your strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. Do you love other people? Well, that capacity for you to love them has to first come from, as the verse says, to love yourself. So you know how you need to be loved. I'd like you to just maybe question why you don't feel like you like who you are. And maybe flip that. What is there about you that's worth loving? What are the things that other people appreciate you? Where is your heart in things? Do you like to help people? Are you there for others when they're down? Then you have some good qualities. And the fact that you're even asking that question, that you want to learn to love yourself, let God show you that. Get some really beautiful Christian mentors around you, some friends that are good friends, that are solid with Jesus, and tell them about your struggle, tell them what you're struggling with, and find some people that can speak into you. What a beautiful thing it is to explore the love of God. And yeah, I just want to encourage you, you are special, you are beautiful. And if you've got things that you need to sort out with God as far as your past or things that you've done wrong or things that you're feeling guilty or shameful for, you know, we have a God who is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And just take that to him, let go of it, and look forward to the future that he has for you. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future.
Thanks, Danny, for answering that tough question. I wouldn't have been able to answer that. But yes, we hope these are helping you girls in whatever you're going through. And please send us your questions.
Yeah. So girls, that's it from us today. You know, I hope that
this episode has encouraged you to just look around you at those needs that you might not be aware of, and just give if you have something to give.
Mm. And tomorrow's devotional is called Shoes on the Mantelpiece.
Oh, yeah.
That's a little sad. Actually, it's a little bit sad story. And we also have a little scoop of Charlotte Bay.
Oh, excellent. Mm-hmm. Exciting things tomorrow, girls. So we will see you tomorrow.
Okay, bye.
Let's pray, girls. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for another day. We're almost to the end of the week, but we ask that you still keep helping us get through it. We ask that you touch our hearts and minds so we can be aware of those that need you and that need help, and give us a kind heart to give what we have and that we know we won't need anymore, Lord. Thank you so much for being with us, and help us this day. In your name, amen. This has been GIGI Radio signing out.